everyone, welcome back to BankExamstoday.com, and today we are going to start with the weekly current affairs of week 2, March 2019. So basically, in this video, we are going to learn about some important national events, international events, reports and indices, banking awareness, news and some miscellaneous events, plus the sports events as well. So we will start with the very first and very important event that took place in Mumbai, and that was the inauguration of first HIV treatment center for the LGBTQ community in India. It wasn't launched by any government body or the government of India. It was launched by Humsafar Trust, which is located in Mumbai, and the same center, the HIV treatment center, is also located in Mumbai. So this center is providing free counseling to the patients of HIV and antiretroviral therapy, which is used to reduce the progression of HIV in the body of the diseased person. Okay, so this is located in Mumbai, very important. Secondly, it is launched by Humsafar Trust. Okay, and it is basically for the people who belong to LGBTQ community. Second important national event is the amendment of enemy property order. So basically, what is an enemy property? Enemy property is the property left by people who migrated to Pakistan during 1947's partition and during Sino-India war in 1962. So most of the property left by the people who migrated to Pakistan is in Uttar Pradesh, and the people who left for China after Sino-India war, the property is in Meghalaya. So the properties are concentrated in these two areas, and government of India allowed that the state governments can put these enemy properties to public use. It means the auction can be arranged, and these properties are exclusively meant for public use, not for the private use. Okay, so this is important, that the property can be exclusively used for the public welfare, not the private welfare. Secondly, the properties for enemy properties are belong to the people who migrated to Pakistan and China, no other country as well. Okay, so this is about the enemy property order. Now we are moving to the Center of Excellence for Differently Abled Person. The third center was recently inaugurated in Bengaluru. Two such centers are already working in Delhi and Noida. And the third center was inaugurated by Hinduja Global Solutions along with the NASCOM Foundation in Bengaluru. So this center is going to train minimum 100 physically able, differently abled person, and out of those 100 people, 50% of the people must be employed. The center will make sure that 50% of the people must be employed in the companies who are willing to hire them. So the center is located in Bengaluru. It was launched by Hinduja Global Solutions along with NASCOM, and minimum 100 people should be there, should be enrolled in this center, and 50% of those people must be employed in the companies who are willing to hire them. So this is Center for Excellence for Differently Abled Person. Then comes the Black Hole Coin. Black Hole Coin was launched by United Kingdom to commemorate Stephen Hawking in the new 50 pence coin known as Black Hole Coin. So basically, this coin will not come into circulation. It is just a commemoration coin for Stephen Hawking. So this coin is inspired by the work of black holes, which were mentioned by the Stephen Hawking's book A Brief History of Time. So you must know that Black Hole Coin was launched to commemorate Stephen Hawking, and the book name of the book is A Brief History of Time, from which the coin is inspired. Moving to the childcare facility by Bank of Baroda. So Bank of Baroda has come up with the facility that they are going to launch a childcare or daycare or crèche facility for its employees. It means any female employee working in the bank can bring the child with her, and that child will be placed in the childcare facility provided by the bank. So the total expenses, out of the total expenses, 60% expenses will be paid by the bank, and the 40% of the expenses will be paid by the parent who is bringing the child. It can be male parent, it can be female parent. It means if the father is working, he can bring the child as well. If the mother is working in the bank, then she can also bring the child for the daycare. But 40% of the expenses should be borne by the parents, and 60% will be borne by the bank. Moving to the Monster Salary Index launched by Monster.com in India, it surveyed around 200 female employees, and after surveying these people, Monster Salary Index came to the conclusion that women in India earn 19% less than the men are earning. It is an average calculation which states that men are earning 19% more than the women in India. And the gap was 20% 1 year ago, and it has zeroed down to just 1%. It means nothing has changed during 1 year. No Me Too movement, no any, no women empowerment effect has been seen on the survey. So men usually earn 46 rupees more than the women in the same industry, in the same environment, and this gap is the most wide in the IT sector, which gives 20% more, 26% more salaries to the male candidates and 26% less to the female candidates. And then in the healthcare sector, this gap is again really very wide, which is 24%, and in the childcare and social services, this gap is 21%. So this is the gap women are facing when they receive the remuneration for the work they do. Okay, during the survey, some men also admit that women are getting less salary for the work they are doing. So it should be removed. This gap should be removed. Then we are coming to the trends in International Arms Transfer 2018. In the report published by Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, and this report states that India has become the second largest importer of the arms. Earlier, India was placed at the first position, but India is superseded by Saudi Arabia, and now Saudi Arabia is the largest importer of weapons in the world. India is following Saudi Arabia. After that, there is Egypt, Australia, and Algeria. Okay, so there is a decline around 9% in the import of weapons in India during 2014 to 2018. Now we are moving to the report by World Gold Council, and this report suggests that India has 11th largest gold reserves with 607 tons of gold in India. India would have been at the place 10 if IMF, which is International Monetary Fund, it is not a country. So IMF is also included in this report. So if we remove IMF and if we only consider the countries, India would have been at the 10th spot, and US is on the top. US is followed by Germany, and then at the third position, IMF is placed. So the most of the gold is with the US, then Germany, then IMF. But India is the largest consumer of gold. Reason: our marriages, functions, the gold we donate in the temples, in the gurdwaras. So many reasons are there that Indians consume more gold than less of the people living in the world. Okay. Now, there is a committee for insurance scheme for lawyers, and this committee is going to be headed by Legal Affairs Secretary Alok Srivastava. He is going to examine the issues related to framing a structured scheme that provides insurance cover to advocates, and also this committee will suggest the modalities. It means how to implement this scheme, and the committee is going to provide its report within 3 months. The thing you need to remember is the name of the head of the committee, which is Alok Srivastava. He will suggest that what should be the pattern of the scheme, what should be the objectives of the schemes and beneficiaries, and then how to implement this scheme. Now, India has signed a $3 billion defense deal with Russia for Chakra 3. So in 2012, India signed a deal with Russia for Chakra 2. Chakra 2 is a nuclear submarine, okay, nuclear attack submarine. And now this lease of Chakra 2 is about to end in 2022, and therefore India has to sign a new deal with Russia, which is of $3 billion worth, okay. And then during this deal, which Russia will provide a new submarine customized with indigenous communication system and sensors, and it will be delivered to India in 2025. Till then, India has asked Germany to extend the deal on Chakra 2. So the lease of Chakra 2 will be extended to 2025, and then Russia will deliver Chakra 3 to India, and then Chakra 2 deal will be, lease will be cancelled. Okay, so it is an Akula class SSN, which is also nuclear attack submarine. The deal is signed with Russia to replace INS Chakra 2. Then we move to the coins released for or launched for visually impaired people. Recently, Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi launched the coins of denomination rupees 1, 2, 5, 10 and 20. And the first coin in the shape of 12 edged polygon with a design of grain was launched. It means we only have circular coins, but this is the first coin which is 12 edged polygon with a design of grain. Grain design represents the importance of farms in our nation. These coins are designed by National Institutes of Design. Okay, so this is very important, the denomination of the coins 1, 2, 5, 10 and 20. The 20 rupee coin is in the shape of 12 edged polygon. The coins are designed by National Institute of Design. Now, very important, two portals, eDharti and eDharti app, eDharti geo portal. So what is eDharti app? eDharti app is an app where three modules, conversion, substitution and mutation of the properties. Conversion means you have to buy a new property, and the property on, suppose the property was with somebody else, somebody else was the owner of the property, and now the name should be converted to the new buyer. That is conversion. Substitution means you have to add new names for the, as the heir of the property. Like my father has to add my name as the owner of the property. That is substitution. And mutation means you have to delete the names of some owners of the property. So all these three things can be done using the eDharti mobile application. And if you want to make payment for in land and Land and Development Office, that can also be done through this eDharti app. And then the second is eDharti Geo Portal, which is for the leasee of the property. It means if anybody has a lease of the property, and that person can see the details of the property. That is by eDharti Geo Portal. That is a web portal, not a mobile application. So eDharti and portal. So these two things were launched by our housing and urban minister, Mr. Hardeep Puri. You know, you must know the ministers in India as well. Now we are moving to some state government launched schemes. So the very first is Mukhya Mantri Anchal Amrit Yojana, launched in Uttarakhand. So Uttarakhand Chief Minister launched this scheme to provide milk to the students or the child who comes to an Anganwadi Kendra. Okay, because milk is a significant part of our diet, and if a child is coming to an Anganwadi center, he should get milk twice a week for free, and government is going to provide 100 ml of milk twice a week for the one child. And under this scheme, 2.5 lakh children will be benefited at 220,000 Anganwadi centers. Important things to remember, launched by Uttarakhand. It is based, or it provides milk To whom? To the kids who come to Anganwadi centers. Secondly, how many children will be benefited? 2.5 lakh children in 20,000 Anganwadi centers. Moving to some banking news. So, Union Bank of India has signed a bank insurance deal with HDFC Life Insurance. Through this deal, HDFC's life's expertise products, like insurance products of HDFC, will be delivered through United Bank of India's branches in India. Why United Bank of India? Because United Bank of India has a very great hold in the rural India, because it has many branches in rural India, and therefore to provide the insurance product to the rural communities, HDFC Life Insurance signed this bank insurance deal with UBI. Okay, now there is one more banking awareness news that I told you that is not my department. Still, I'm going to tell you that RBI has eases business guidelines for white label ATMs. So first of all, what are white label ATMs? White label ATMs are not operated or owned by any bank. These are operated by non-banking financial organizations or companies, that is NBFCs. Okay, so when these white label ATMs are operated, you do not see any logo of any bank. Okay, so the company which is launching white label ATMs must have a sponsor bank. Sponsor bank, in case there is a failed transaction through the ATM, the person must go somewhere to file a complaint that my transaction is cancelled, the check, the cash did not come out. So there should be one sponsor bank which provides the cash to the company and handle the failed transactions or payment settlements. Okay, but during demonetization in 2016, these companies who operate white label ATMs were not getting enough cash for their ATMs. So RBI is now has eased these guidelines. It states that these companies should not go to the sponsor bank in case they require cash. They can directly go to RBI to get the cash, or they can go to currency chests. Now this term, what is currency chest? Chest is basically drawers, many drawers combined together. But in a banking system, currency chest is the branches of Reserve Bank of India where the cash is withheld with them. In case RBI needs cash, RBI cannot operate in all the cities, all the rural areas of the country. So it has some banks, the branches of the banks that can deliver cash to the other banks as well. And those banks are known as currency chest of our banking system. So these white label ATM operators can go to RBI directly, like any RBI office, and any currency chest or any scheduled bank. They can get the cash above 1 lakh. It means below 1 lakh, they cannot get the cash. So they have to buy the cash above 1 lakh in any multiples, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, any multiples. And now the second ease in provided to these white label ATMs is that they can issue co-branded ATM. It means that if there is a white label company, let's say company A signed a co-branded ATM card with bank SBI. So that if I'm going to the white label ATM and I have an SBI card and that bank has signed a co-branded deal with SBI, then I will not be charged for any money for using my card at any other ATM. That is charged by the banks, right? So the customers will get honest transaction benefit. Honest transaction, the card and the ATMs are of the same bank. Second, these white label ATMs can provide bill payment services and other services, but they have to get a certification from NPCI. Secondly, to maximize their income or benefits, or you can say they can get more money, they can display advertisements in their premises of the ATM. It means you enter the ATM, suppose I go to an SBI ATM. So all I see the logo of SBI, the products of SBI, but these white label operators can display any kind of advertisement. It depends upon them. It can be a non-financial product. They can advertise a mobile phone or any kind of eatable product or commodity. Does not matter, because they are not bound to display any other bank's products, right? So this is about the EAST guidelines for white label ATMs. Now we're moving to Atal Ahar Yojana, launched by Government of Maharashtra. So Government of Maharashtra is bound or is willing to provide subsidized food for the construction workers. Okay, and for this purpose, Government of Maharashtra launched Atal Ahar Yojana, which will provide good quality food at rupees 5 only. And this scheme will be launched in a phased manner. In the very first phase, 20,000 workers will be covered. And then this scheme will be launched in different phases, covering more workers engaged in construction work. Okay, so the amount for the food provided to these workers will be only 5 rupees. Moving to the cloud seeding project of Varsha Dhare. Varsha Dhare basically is launched by the government of Karnataka, which is facing drought from 3 years. And now this is the fourth year, and government is scared that what happens if there is a drought for the consecutive 4 years. Okay, and to tackle this possibility, government of Karnataka launched cloud seeding process. And this project will be carried by Hosala Projects Private Limited for the 60 days. Okay, what will happen during this project? So during these 60 days, 3 Doppler radars will detect the rain bearing clouds, because we are going to have monsoon season in Karnataka, and during these 60 days 3 Dopplers will detect that which cloud is bearing rain, and then these Dopplers will fly above those clouds and they will disperse silver iodide. Silver iodide, what will it do? It will condense the raindrops and it will help in rain in those areas. So this is about Varsha Dhare project in Karnataka. Moving to appointments, Soumya Swaminathan, who is a pediatrician and a clinical scientist, has been appointed as chief scientist of the World Health Organization. Padma Lakshmi, who is an author, model, host, many things, and she has been appointed as United Nations Goodwill Ambassador. Then Mohammad Shataya, the Prime Minister of Palestine, C. Lal Sota, first chairman of Loka Youth of Mizoram. So this is important. Subhash Chandra Garg, Finance Secretary of India. Moving to the awards and honors. Priyanka Dubey has won Chameli Devi Jain Award for being an outstanding women journalist. Former RBI government Raghuram Rajan has won Yashwant Rao Chavan in National Award 2018. Yashwant Rao Chavan was the first CM of Maharashtra. And the Biju Patnaik Airport in India has won the Airport Service Quality Award 2018. Our Vice President Mr. Venkaiah Naidu has been honored with Doctor Honoris Causa. It means the Doctor of Philosophy by University of Peace of Costa Rica. Echo Channel Insurance has won the Golden Peacock Innovative Product Award. Important days: 8th March, International Women's Day; 10th March, National Immunization Day; and March 14, World Kidney Day. So World Kidney Day is basically celebrated or observed on the second Saturday of March, which falls on 14th March this year. So we celebrated 14th March as World Kidney Day. The themes for International Women's Day: think equal, build smart, and innovate for change. Think equal, because women should be considered equal to men. There should be no gender discrimination. Moving to sports, and a 16-year-old chess player named P. Inian has become the 61st Grandmaster of India by winning Noisel Open in France. Kavinder Singh Bist, who is a boxer, has won a gold medal in 56 kg category at 38th GB Boxing Tournament. Upamanyu Datta, He brought India's first medal in bronze in the laser standard race for men in the Asian Open Laser Sailing Championship. So he, Upimanyu Datta, is from Mumbai, and he brought India's first medal in the laser standard race. So India never won any kind of medal in this sport, but he did it. And Olympic champion Liu Hong has broke the world record in the 50-kilometer race walk. So what is race walk? Race walk is that it is a kind of race where 1 foot of the participant should be at ground. While we are running, sometimes it happens that both of our feet are above the ground. But in the race walk, one of the foot should seem at the ground. And she has become the first woman to break the 4-hour barrier in the event. And this is Liu Hong from... Now we are moving to miscellaneous. So three things got geographical tag. First is Mara Yuri Jaggery from Idukki, Iro Turmeric from Tamil Nadu, and Ereka Nut from or Sirisiri Supari from Uttar Kannada of Karnataka. These three things have got GI tag. And Indian and Oman's joint military exercise Al Niga was held at Oman. The venue is very important. And Ken Tanaka, 116-year-old Japanese woman, is given the world record of world's oldest living person. So the second last is that Dictionary of Martyrs of India's Freedom Struggle was released by Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi, and Thakurani Jatra Festival is a festival for the weavers. So weavers consider that Thakurani is their goddess of weavers, and this festival is celebrated in Odisha by the weavers. Okay, so these are all the miscellaneous news, and thank you for watching this video. I think the colors and my t-shirt are matching, so doesn't matter. So you can write your emails at insa@bankexamstoday. You can call us on 9067201000, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.